Hello and welcome to my channel. Since many of you were asking for a new version of my large group base, The Unknown, I had to redesign it just for you. But before we dive into the details, I want to say a big thank you for your incredible support. We've just hit 10k subscribers, which is absolutely mind-blowing for me. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, I'd appreciate it if you could hit that button. Now let's talk about what's new in The Unknown V2. First, I've added a strong funnel and mini China wall to improve your raid defense experience. Next, we have a massive open core with ramp peaks, which is a game changer. And don't forget the reworked shooting floor and the wide gap footprint, giving us even more powerful peaks. So, that's about it. Now we start with a base tour. We open the TC by building a roof right here. The upkeep is roughly 10k metal, as you can see. This time, we have disconnectable bunker TCs. Simply place a roof on this foundation, and the TC will disconnect by breaking the frame. To reconnect it, just rebuild two triangle frames. As we step into the first compound, we got some peaks on the left and right, which can be useful for retaking it. It's covered by multiple turrets from various angles. We got this outside peak on each side, where you can easily deal with door campers. You also got a peek into the gap of these two compound sections. I've added barricades to slow down anyone trying to break in or move around. Here's a little funnel wall section with two shotgun traps and a flame turret. We've got a separated area for furnaces, divided by chain link fences, and another funnel wall section to make it harder for raiders to take control inside the compound. And as I said, outside peaks on this side as well. Here we are entering the mini China wall. And as you can see, breaching in here isn't fun. There are so many different turret angles, it's actually very hard to breach. We got some outside peaks as well to defend your compound from inside. There is enough space for batteries in here, and I've separated it with garage doors. Moving on, we have the entrance to the main base, which looks similar to the first unknown version. We got some nasty roof peaks on the left and right. They are perfect for defending your China wall and holding off any breach attempts. Up here we have a little outside peak, which can be used as an early shooting floor. Perfect for defending your base and the early stages of a wipe. But also great angles if you've already built the mini China wall. There are two bedrooms on each side, giving us a total of 12 bedrooms at these outside peaks. Entering the inner ring, we also got multiple turret angles. And some drop-off space in the vending machines. Here we enter the main base core, with an airlock, pretty useful in early game. We have tons of space for loot on the first layer, as well as room for bags, a workbench and a repair bench. Jumping up to the second layer, we got the same amount of loot space. Third layer is a bedroom area, especially for early raid defenses. But they come in handy later on in a wipe as well. These bedrooms are connected with the inner peaks. And these inner peaks are also connected with the outside peaks, offering excellent mobility overall. Jumping up here, we got some peaks for retake, which can also hide your loot. There are a total of 6 hidden loot boxes. Here we have the spacious open core with plenty of room for boxes. It's well protected by 2 rim turrets on each side. Down here, we find some more retake peaks into the open core. along with additional hidden loot on all six sites. In total, we have six bunkers that are, of course, unsplashable. To open them, simply place the triangle roof right here. Each bunker has space for four large boxes. And this section is also connected to the inner and outside peaks. Moving up, we have a room for batteries and another bedroom. Up here we got a bedroom area, which is directly connected to the wide gap shooting floor. Each bedroom got these ram peaks in case you have to defend your open core. And here is the shooting floor. There are some great wide angles from these wide gaps right here. And more angles from this little drop down over here. There is another drop down with a bed and even more angles. I love this peek behind the door because it allows you to defend your compound even if there is a massive raid base tower outside. I defended the space last wipe with an M2 silencer from here, and the raiders had a hard time finding me in these lower peaks. Here are some roof peaks for retaking control during top-down raids. One layer up is a roof level with quick respawn bedrooms and space for batteries. There are additional roof peaks over here. We have a huge, spacious roof with tons of angles to surprise raiders or roof camp. No, you better don't roof camp. So that wraps up the base tour, and now we can dive into the building tutorial. Let's start building the starter base. This is a regular circle. We are building the second floor now. Now we are building the third floor, which is also the entrance to the inner peaks. And next we are building the multi-tizi. Go out 4 squares and end with a triangle. Remove all squares. Go back with triangles. Now we go out 3 squares and end with a triangle. Remove all squares. Go back with triangles. Now we are building the white gaps and the external tizi. We are building an external tizi bunker. Place the tizi here and walls on the left and right of it. Now you need to build a freehand square. If the gap is not too large and the wall has 77% stability, it's perfect. You can close the gap with a window. You can also use the frame to close the gap, but make sure to upgrade the frame only to stone. Now we connect the multi-tizi with the white gaps. Now we are building the outside wall. This is the early shooting floor. Now we are building the inner peaks. Now we are building the open core. Thank you. We need to build the frames because they are important for stability. On the right side of each door, extending into the inner peaks. Now we are building the 6 open core bunkers. Always check if the bunker still opens after you're done. The gap is important, make sure it's right. Now we are building the China wall, along with the frames. Next step is building the shooting floor. Thank you. Now we are building the roof. Now we are building the compound funnel wall. The compound is a bit tricky to place, but it's always possible.